can you see that you've got a cycle that is then amplifying all of that energy?
Going back about 3 years or so ago now, I was knocking about with a Freemason who's high up in the degrees, an esoteric magic practicing Freemason, high up in the degrees, who was entertaining the notion of getting together eight people to form a ritual. I think he would be the ninth person. There was going to be either eight or nine people total in that ritual. But I didn't think it was ever going to happen, and I thought it was a bit of a pipe dream, so to speak. The modern shaman who has been a guest, for want of another name, the modern shaman being a guest to this channel, he's mentioned being part of a ritual with 12 people, a circle, and sort of just mentioning that that number works, just works, as he put it. And I think it also kind of resonated with the zodiac. Now, coming up is something from Peter Paget, and what he's sort of saying resonates with much of the themes that are on my channel also. I've got permission off Miles Johnson before to use footage off his channel, so I don't think there'll be any problem with that. Enjoy.
I have seen people, I have worked with people who can, of their own capacity, change the weather. I had an association with a guy called Tim many moons ago, and he was a storm man. He was a storm chaser. He loved storms, loved lightning, loved drama. And he arrived at my house in Devon at the time, and he said, "I have to warn you, I called in storms. I like storms." "Yeah, okay." I thought, okay, that's cool. He's causing storms. That morning, after he'd stayed overnight, out of a virtually clear sky, then one cloud, there was the most enormous clap of thunder that you heard and lightning strike that I've ever seen in my life. I came down to breakfast and said, "Was that?" "Yeah, that was me. I'm sorry about that." He could call in storms. Your capacity to change and affect your personal reality is far greater than you have ever been told. Whenever three shall meet, my church is there. Not my quote, somebody else's quote. You know who I'm talking about. If you've got three people, this is my best art. Their three beingness, I'm not even going to say mind, brain, I'm just going to sort of invent a word. Their actual being, your being, is at any one time both receiving and transmitting energy. That energy interacts with the people around you. As you are all sitting here, you are to a degree in tune with each other, I would hope. You seem to be in tune with each other. Hopefully I'm in tune with you. And if you take three people and you put them in some kind of proximity to each other physically within about 6 feet, they will be interacting in their energy fields. This is referred to people in very general terms as aura. An aura is a series of density lines in energy, like a magnetic field, which extends around all things. And we're talking plants as well, we're not just talking mammals. Indeed, you know, some crystals have auras. And you're talking again energy, waveform going out here. Now, as an individual, yes, you do have a certain amount of ability to affect your local situation, your event horizons, what happens to you, your body, your own body in particular, because you've got X trillion cells in your body, which you are in control of. If this person is transmitting, and that person here is picking it up and transmitting, and this person here is picking it up and transmitting, can you see that you've got a cycle that is then amplifying all of that energy? So by having a minimum of three, or any function of three, 3, 6, 9, 12, you are going to have an amplifier, just like this box of tricks back here, which is operating the mic, which I'm not using. You are going to amplify your intent. And we'll cover that later in the training session. Your intentions are principally what governs where you're going to go, who you're going to call in, what you're going to reject, what you're going to reflect. For those who are interested, I'm a Mayan White 5 mirror. So what you see in me at any one time is only a reflection of you. You can only see me as how you think I am. If I asked for a detailed painting or version of me from different ones of you, you would draw, you'd paint something slightly different. I am, anything is, a reflection of you. So how you arrange and govern yourself, your philosophy, your culture, whatever it is, you will see that out there. Hence, people who follow various cults, religions, political or philosophical beliefs will see things in their own, thank you, in their own light. So how you arrange and govern yourself, your philosophy, your culture, whatever it is, you will see that out there. Hence, people who follow various cults, religions, political or philosophical beliefs will see things in their own, thank you, in their own light.